From the glossary of empowerment. Buddhic plane and Buddhic body. The fifth plane of the seven major planes of reality upon which all human beings function. The Buddhic plane is the higher frequency octave of the astral plane. It's the plane of devotion and ecstasy. So these planes are dimensional fields and they all overlap each other. So they're all really just one reality, but for the sake of understanding the depth of transformation and evolution, spiritual evolution, we separate them out so that we can really understand how this operates. In many ancient traditions, this plane of reality is known as the realm of the gods and goddesses. So on the Buddhic plane exist this state, these kind of conglomerations of higher consciousness, and we call them deities, gods, goddesses. When you identify with a divine entity, you're engaging directly with the Buddhic plane. Here, your own individual identity becomes merged into the collective body of humanity, and all the pain and anguish of the lower planes are transformed into an all-encompassing love. As you purify your DNA of its ancestral memories and shadow patterns, so you gradually come to know a new life on the Buddhic plane. It kind of explains it well. You know, that plane of reality is the plane that sits inside us, that we naturally inhabit at some other level of consciousness. And so when we seek on the astral plane is the lower counterpart in the lower worlds, the emotional body. It's all our emotions and desires. So our yearning is because we are yearning for that higher place that also exists inside us, outside of space and time, that love, that pure love. And so all our desires are really longings for that, to return to that state, to live in the place where once we lived as gods or goddesses, because in our far, far past, we were that, and in our far future, or even less far, we will be that again. And part of the illusion of our lives is constructed in order that we can return to those states of all-pervading love. So we have to kind of transmute the ancestral pain of humanity in order to return to those higher planes of consciousness. And then we have the Buddhic body, the fifth major subtle layer of your aura corresponding to the Buddhic plane. Your Buddhic body is only accessible to you once your heart has completely opened. All true higher mystical experiences or revelations come through your heart and are therefore rooted in the Buddhic body. This is actually a body in which you have your being. It's there now. It's just, there are faculties closed down, so it's not even dormant, it's just available to you. It's waiting for grace, you know, it's waiting for the right moment when things will just come together for you as you take your spiritual journey further. And you have to soften these wounds around your heart, and you have to open them up, these shadows, and forgive yourself and forgive others and move gradually back into the heart. And then the Buddhic plane becomes accessible and you begin to inhabit your Buddhic body. Once your awareness is fully anchored in the Buddhic body, the causal body dissolves and reincarnation in the normal sense is no longer possible. So this is part of the metaphor, the allegory of these seven subtle bodies. That the causal body, which is the one just below the body in the Buddhic body in frequency, the causal body is the one that keeps us returning. And the causal body has this incredibly pure consciousness that keeps us returning and returning in the samsara cycle, the incarnative cycle, so that we're polishing this stone, this mirror, over the many, many eons as we come in and out of the form and we come down into the lower trinity, the lower bodies. And slowly as we purify those bodies, then we get to a point where when the consciousness is so anchored in love, in the Buddhic body, then the causal body is no longer needed and it dissolves. And so we finally escape this cycle of incarnation, this samsara, and we enter into these nirvana states. The Buddhic body also corresponds to the mystical state of absorption, the fourth and fifth initiation, which is what occurs as your awareness becomes stabilized in the higher frequencies. It represents the third feminine realm of the divine trinity, that of divine activity or compassionate action. So a lot of kind of things to kind of contemplate there. The mystical state of absorption is once your contemplation has gone into a very deep place over a period of time, many, many years, many, many incarnations, then the purification that's taken place in your subtle bodies begins to pick up a pace, and a radiance starts to emerge through you. And it's like you begin to pick up escape velocity. You know, you've picked up enough frequency, high frequency, to begin to escape the lower planes. Not that you escape them, but you just grow beyond them, through them, and you know, out into the higher reaches of inner space. And there we, you know, this state of absorption takes us over, and absorption is a state in which the light in our aura starts to kind of catalyze higher functioning of our endocrine glands, and those functionings allow us to access physically in our chemistry those higher states of consciousness, because hormones are released through the brain and into the chemistry, because they're synthesized deep in the laboratory of the body, and they allow us to perceive the inner light and to even begin to merge our whole being into that inner light. So absorption, it's something that occurs naturally at a certain point in our spiritual evolution, and it's a time when we will have to begin to close down our outer faculties and enter into deep meditative states for long periods of time, because the absorption just takes you. So something to look forward to.